police saw stories of bravery and selflessness. Check out this rescue video of the Coast Guard swooping in to save a man and his dog. Their boat stopped working off the coast of Sanibel. The two were airlifted when the boat started taking on water. Sheriff's office was in action all over Fort Myers Beach, helping anybody in need.
Awake News reporter Paul Dolan is live in the studio. And Paul, tell us about these rescues.
Lois, Thursday night on Fort Myers Beach, these deputies braved Hurricane Helene's wind, rain, and surge, risking their lives to save others.
Launching a rescue boat into the Fort Myers Beach darkness, Hurricane Helene's indifferent storm surge was overwhelming the island. But amid a knee-deep flood and howling winds, the Lee County Sheriff's Office had a job to do.
We deploy resources throughout the entire county at the press of a button.
Despite the dangers, swamp buggies responded to Sheriff Marcino's button, rescuing stranded victims by pushing rescue boats through the chaotic storm. Only a few examples of a busy Thursday night for LCSO.
Over 100 calls for service, many rescues going on. I mean, we had people being rescued in boats, in jet skis, all-terrain vehicles. Again, it's all hands on deck.
Waves pummeling the island town, plunging it down a near two-year memory lane, back to Hurricane Ian.
And it's almost deja vu. You think about Hurricane Ian and how hard we got hit. Saving lives, protecting lives, and making sure people are safe, that's always first and foremost.
So, to Sheriff Marcino, each one of these rescues means a job well done. During severe weather, saving lives is what matters. And that's why Friday morning, Marcino proudly announced,
"Thank God we didn't lose anyone throughout this storm. We have zero reports of any fatalities. That makes me feel so good."
The Lee County Sheriff's Office rescued people using jet skis, all-terrain vehicles, and boats. And now, Fort Myers Beach can begin to recover. Back to you.